Good morning. Today, let's start our day with a new chapter, that is chapter number 14, factorization. Now, what is factorization? Factorization means to write an expression as a product of its factors. Means that to factorize is nothing but we write the given expression as the product of its factors. Means we break the expression as product of its factors. These factors may be numbers, algebraic values or algebraic expressions. Means whatever factors we are getting of an expression as product, they may be numbers or algebraic variables like x, y, p, q, t, s, any variable, or algebraic expression that is x plus 3, x plus 2, 2x minus 5, any such expression. So factors may be numbers, algebraic variables or algebraic expressions. There are systematic methods to factorize these algebraic expressions. Now, to factorize the algebraic expression, we use systematic methods. Let's see these methods. So the first method is method of common factors. Means according to this method, whatever algebraic expression is given, we will take out the common factors from that algebraic terms or expressions. Let us understand this by an example. Factorize 3x plus 9. Now, let us see how we take out the common factors. We know that 3x, I give the factors 3 into x. Means 3 into x is the factor of 3 and x. Here you can say 3x is the product of 3 into x. And 9 is the product of 3 into 3. So, we write 3x plus 9 equal to 3 into x plus 3 into 3. So, first, whatever terms are given in the algebraic expression, we have found out separately the product of the given terms. Now, after finding the product of the given terms, let us see that we can see something common from these terms. Now, when we see both the brackets, we can see that 3 is common on both the sides. That is, in both the brackets, 3 is common. Also, by distributive law, we know that we have learned distributive law. The distributive law states that A into B plus C equal to A into B plus A into C. This is what the distributive law states. So, according to distributive law also, we know that 3 into x plus 2 equal to, first we have to multiply 3 by x. Here first we will multiply by 3 by x, then we will multiply 3 by 2. And as there is a sign of plus in between x and 2, we will use the sign of plus. So, we write 3 into x plus 3 into 3. So, we can write 3x plus 9 equal to 3 into x plus 2, which is in short written as 3 into in bracket x plus 2. Yes, this is how we will take out the common from the given terms of any algebraic expression. Now we can read of its factors. They are 3 and x plus 2. Now easily we can see that the given algebraic expression, that is 3x plus 9, this when we factorize by taking out common, we can see that we are getting as product of two factors, that is 3, one is 3 and another is x plus 2. So we can read it the factors as 3 and x plus 2. These factors are irreducible. Now, further, we cannot reduce both the given factors, because we know 3 is all is having the factors 1 into 3, but we don't use 1 generally as a when writing the factors. So we write 3 as it is, and x plus 2 we cannot factorize, sorry, we cannot reduce further. So these factors are irreducible, so we'll stop there. Now another method of solving the factorizing is factors by regrouping terms. Here, in certain cases, the given expression cannot be factorized easily, but by rearranging the terms, we can form groups leading to factorization. Now, some algebraic expressions are arranged in such a way that we cannot factorize them directly or easily. For that, what we do? First, we rearrange the terms of the given algebraic expression, and then we form the groups of the given terms and then factorize it. Let's understand this also by solving some examples. So for example, let us take number one example as 3x plus 9 plus 2xy plus 6y. Yes. Now you can see in the question itself that there are 4 terms in the given algebraic expression, and from that 4 terms we have made 2 groups. Groups we have made in such a way that directly we can see we have made the first group as 3x plus 9, another group as 2xy plus 6y. You can see that 3x plus 9 we can take out 3 common, because 3 and 9 both comes in the table of 3. Similarly, from 2xy plus 6y we can take out number 2 common, because 2 and 6 comes in the table of 2, and another variable, that is y, because y is there in both the terms. In such a way, already the terms are arranged, but we have made the groups. So we first make it a groups, so we'll write equal to now 3x plus 9. So first we will find the product of 3x separately and 9 plus 9 separately. That is, we know 3x can be written as 3 into x. Here you can see 3x is written as 3 into x plus 9 as it is, and factors of 9 are 3 into 3. Similarly, another group, 2xy factors are 2 into x into y. Plus 6y, again 6y factors are 2 into 3 into y, because 6 is 2 3s are 6 and factor of y is y only. So we separately make the factors of each term. Now after making the factors, finding the factors of each term, let's see what we can see, take out common. Now again you can see from these two terms, that is first term 3x and another term 9, we can take out 3 common from both. This 3 is present in both the terms, so we'll take out 3 common. After taking out 3 common, here it is left x plus sign as it is, we'll write, and here it will be left 3. So we'll write x plus 3 in bracket after taking out 3 as common from the first group, that is from the first two terms. Yes, so we'll write 3 outside the bracket and remaining factors in the bracket, that is x plus 3. Now another group, when we see, yes, we can see that here we can take out 2 is there in the first term also, and second term of the second group, again x is there, but next term is not having x, so we can see that y is there in both the terms, so we'll select y also. So we can take out 2y common in the next group, that is second group, and now again what will be left here, you can see x plus 3, this is left. So we take out 2y common from the second group and write the remaining factors in the bracket, that is x plus 3. So we get from the first group 3 common and remaining x plus 3 in bracket we write, and from the second group we can take out common 2y and remaining x plus 3 in the bracket. Now again you can see that we are having two terms only. This is one term, 3 into x plus 3, that is one term, and another term is 2y into x plus 3. These are two terms. From these two terms, again you can see this x plus 3 is same, yeah, you can say common in both the terms. So again we will take out x plus 3 out as it is common and write the remaining terms in the another bracket. So we will write equal to x plus 3 into 3 plus 2y. After taking out this common, we will be left with 3 plus sign and this 2y. So we'll write this remaining in the another bracket as 3 plus 2y. So on factorizing the given expression, we will get, you can see we get the product in the form of factors. You can see this is x plus 3, there nothing is there, means it is the sign of into, and this is 3 plus 2y. Yes. So in this way, after grouping, we can factorize the given expression. Let's see another example. Example number 2. 6xy minus 4y plus 6 minus 9x. Here again, here, let's see that if we make a group, can we take out common and again we can follow. Here if we make, you can see 6 and 4 both comes in the table of 2 and y is common, so we can take out 2y common here. Here 6 and 9 both comes in the table of 3, so we can take out 3 common. But after seeing the numbers and variables, you have to take care of sign also. So when we take out the common, yes, here you will be left with 3x minus 2, and here you will get 2 minus 3x after taking out common, means sign in both the brackets will be changed. So we rearrange the given terms of the expression, that is we will write equal to 6xy minus 4y minus 9x plus 6. Here we have rearranged, first we have written minus 9x and then we have taken plus 6 like this. Now after rearranging we have made the group. So first group you can see that is 6xy minus 4y, and another group is minus 9x plus 6. You have to take care of the sign also. Now further, after making the group, let's make the product, write the factors of each term separately. That is 6xy is written as 2 into 3 into x into y. That is factors of 6xy are 2 into 3 into x into y. Similarly, factors of minus 4y, minus sign we have written in between, and 4y is 2 into 2 into y. Yes. So then a minus sign as it is, and 9x. So 9x factors are 3 into 3 into x. Yes. Then this minus, as we have taken this in bracket, this plus minus will become minus. So whenever there is a sign of minus in between first and second group, then the second term of sign of second group will change. If it is plus, it will become minus, and if it is minus, it will become plus. Again, factors of 6 are 2 into 3. Yes. So first separately we have written the factors of each term of the given expression. Now let's see what common we can take out from the first group and the second group. Here you can see from the first group we can take out 2 2, these both are having 2 2, so we have taken out 2 common, and y, so 2y we have taken out common, remaining this 3x and this 2, this is remaining, so we'll write 3x, this minus sign, 3x minus 2 in another bracket. Similarly, for the next group, Yes, again let us see what we can take out. We can take out three common. Nothing else is, you can see, common between both the terms of the second group. So remaining we will write 3x minus 2, this part in bracket. So we will get in from the first group 2y common, remaining 3x minus 2 in bracket. Similarly from the second group we will take 3 common and remaining 3x minus 2 in the bracket. Again you can see that from both the terms 3x minus 2 bracket part is common. So we'll take out that is equal to 3x minus 2 and remaining factors in the another bracket we'll write, that is 2y minus 3. This will be left 2y minus 3. So we'll write it in another bracket, that is we will get 3x minus 2 into 2y minus 3 as the product of the given expression. So in this way we can factorize the given expression using regrouping method. Now the difference between the common method and regrouping method is that common method you can use for a expression starting with two terms, means it may be two terms, three terms, four terms, many terms also if possible you can take out common. But for our regrouping method compulsory we need four terms or three terms. So we can arrange the three terms and take out common and then factorize. Either we can rearrange and make groups of four terms and then we can take out common and further we can factorize. Based on these methods, let's solve exercise 14.1. So question number 1 of exercise 14.1, that is find the common factors of the given terms. For that question number 1 is given as, on the separate terms are given and we have to find the common factors of the given terms. The first question is, two terms are 12x and 36. First, let's make the factors of 12x. That is 12x, we can write 12 is the factor is 4 into 3, which can further be factorized as 2 into 2 into 3. And x we have to write as it is. So we will write 12x equal to 2 into 2 into 3, that is factors of 12 and x as it is. So 12x equal to 2 into 2 into 3 into 36 factors are, you know, 4 9s are 36. Factors of 4 are there again, that is 2 into 2, and factors of 9 are 3 into 3. So we write factors of 36 equal to 2 into 2 into 3 into 3. Now from this we have to take out common. So you can see this 1 time 2, that is common. Second time also 2 is common in both the terms. And 1 time 3 is common in both the terms. So common factors will be equal to 2 into 2 into 3, that is equal to 12. Next question number 2. Terms are 2x and 22xy. Let's find the factors of first 2x, that is equal to 2 into x. Now factors of 22xy, that is, you know, 22 is 2, 11s are 22. So and factors xy are x into y. So we get the factors of 22xy is equal to 2 into 11 into x into y. Yes. Now let's see what is common between both the terms. Here you can see 2, 1 time is common in both the terms. Then here you can see x and x also common in both the terms. So we will get common factors equal to 2 into x, that is equal to 2x. Next question number 3, terms are 14pq and 28p² q². First let write the factors of both the terms, that is 14pq equal to, we know 2 7s are 14 and P factors of PQRP into Q. So we will write factors of 14PQ equal to 2 into 7 into P into Q. Next term factors, that is 28P square Q square, factors are 28, that is 4, 7s are 28, and again 4 can be factorized for thus, that is 2 into 2. So we get the factors of 28 as 2 into 2 into 7. Now P square factors are P into P and Q square factors are Q into Q. So we write the factors of 28 P square Q square equal to 2 into 2 into 7 into P into P into Q into Q. Now let's see what is common between both the terms. Here you can see 1 time 2 is common, then 1 time 7 is common, then 1 time P is common, and 1 time Q is, sorry, this is Q and this is Q. 1 time Q is common. So already underlined is there. You can see 1 time 2 is common, both here 7 is common, one time P and one time Q is common. Yes, so common factors equal to 2 into 7 into P into Q, that is equal to 14 PQ. Next question number 4, terms are 2x, 3x square and 4. Factors of 2x equal to 2 into x, factors of 3x square equal to 3 into x into x, factors of 4 equal to 2 into. Now you can see that from the factors of all the three terms, we can see nothing is common. No numerical value we can see common, no variable we can see common, but we know that 1 is the factor of each and every number. So we write common factor equal to 1. So whenever no other number than 1 or variable is common, we take out 1 as a common factor. Next, question number 5. Terms are 6abc, 24ab square, 12a square b. Factors of 6abc are 2 into 3 into a into b into c. C will come. By mistake, c is not there. Here c will be coming. C is there. Now factors of 24ab square is equal to 24, that is 8, 3s are 24, and factors of 8 are 2 into 2 into 2. So we get the factors of 24ab square as 2 into 2 into 2 into 3 into a into b into b. Here you can see 2 into 2 into 2 into 3 into a into b, because a is one time and b is two time. Here please write c. Yes, now let's see what are the factors of 12 a square b. 12 a square b equal to, we know 4, 3s are 12, and again further factorizing 4, we will get 2 into 2. So factors of 12 are 2 into 2 into 3. Factors of a square are a into a and b into b. Yes, b one time, so we will write it as one time only. Now from this, let's see what is common. You can see as given, underline is given already, that common is here 1 time 2 we can see, this 1 time 2 we can see, then 1 time 3 we can see, because all the three terms are having 1 time 3 common. Then we can see 1 time a common in all the three terms, and 1 time b common in all the three terms. So common factors are 2 into 3 into a into b, that is equal to 6ab. Next, question number 6, that is 16x cube minus 4x square and 32x. Factors of 16x cube equal to 16 is 4, 4s are 16, again factors of 4 are 2 into 2 and another 4, that is 2 into 2. So we'll get 2 into 2 into 2 into 2, that is 4 times 2. Factors of our cube, that is 3 times x. So we'll write 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into x into x into x. Now factors of minus 4x square. Here again, as minus sign is there, please write minus 1 with it. So we will write minus 1 and factors of 4 are 2 into 2 and x square, that is x into x. So we will get the factors of minus 4x square equal to minus 1 into 2 into 2 into x into x. Now factors of 32x, that is 32 is 16, 2s are 32. And again factors of 16, that is 16 is 2, 4 times 2. And 32 is 5 times 2. These simple things you have to keep in mind now for making the factors of given numbers. So 32, that is 5 times 2 into x. So we will write 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into x. Now after factorizing, let us see what is common in between the three terms, which factors are common in from the three terms. So you can see 1 times 2 we can take, this is 1 times 2 we can take here, this 1 times 2, then this another time 2 we can take because there are there, and this x also you can see that it is present in all the three terms, 1 times x. Yes. So common factor is equal to 2 into 2 into x, that is equal to 4x. Next question number 7. 10pq, another term 20qr and third term 30rp. Factors of 10pq equal to 2 into 5 into p into q. Factors of 20qr, that is 4 5s are, so again factorizing 4 will get 2 into 2 into 5 into q into r. 30rp, that is factors of 30 is 6 5s are 30, that is 2 into 3 into 5 into r into p. We have to make the factors of the given terms till we cannot further reduce it, that is irreducible factors we have to make. Already we have learned that factors we are taking out as prime numbers only and the variables separately. Each variable you have to write separately. Now looking, after factoring the all the three terms separately, let us see what is common between them. You can see in the factors, that is 1 times 2, here you can see 1 times 2 is common and here 1 times 5 is common. So common factors equal to 2 into 5, that is 10. Question number 8, 3x square y cube, next term 3x cube y square, and third term 6x square y square z. So first let's make the factors of 3x square y cube, that is 3 into x because x square is there, into y into y into y because y is 3 times. Now factors of 10x cube y square equal to, factors of 10 is 2 into 5, factors of x cube is x into x into x, and factors of y square equal to y into y. So factors of 10x cube y square equal to 2 into 5 into x into x into x into y into y. Third term, that is 6x square y square z, that is factors of 6 are 2 into 3. Factors of x square are x into x. Factors of y square are y into y. And factors of z is z only. So we get the factors of 6x square y square z equal to 2 into 3 into x into y into z. Now let's see what is common. You can see that common factors here. Numbers, numerical, no number is common in between because here 3 is there. In the second term 3 is not there. Now second and third term 2 is there but first term 2 is not there. Second term is having 5 but first and third term is not having 5 number. So no number is common. Let's see the variable. Here you can see x 1 time, again x second time also, then you can see y one time and y again another time. So we will get common factors as equal, common factor equal to x into x into y into y. You can see 2 times x common and 2 times y common. So that is equal to x square y square. Dear students, please copy all these in your regular CFW in neat and clean handwriting. Thank you.